we are just getting started here. Next up tonight, a story about a man's passion for pipes, as in pipe organs. 12 News Morning anchor Patrick Palantonio will explain. He's with my 5 o'clock co-anchor Toya Washington at the historic Pabst Theater in downtown Milwaukee.
Take a look at this spectacular theater. I mean, it's really no wonder why they call this Milwaukee's Jewel Box. Good evening.
It's a beautiful place. We're standing in the upper balcony of a theater named after brewing magnate Captain Frederick Pabst.
Now, this is home to the Milwaukee Rep, and right now it's home to A Christmas Carol.
And tonight we're taking you to a Christmas concert and to a theater of a different kind. It's a bit off the beaten path, but well worth the trip. Out here, very close to where Lake Michigan meets Racine County, the soundtrack comes from Mother Earth. That is, until the walking path runs out and a different sound rises. That's Fred Hermes. And this is his organ.
I started playing the organ when I was 8 years old. That's when I bought my first organ.
The Wurlitzer isn't his first, but it is a prized possession. The two have been one for more than a half century. Fred bought it in the 1950s, then moved the massive instrument from the Michigan Theater in Detroit to Caledonia.
2,700 pipes in the organ. Plus there's all the wind chests and bolts and screws and, I mean, after all, it's four rooms of equipment.
The whole house is built around the organ.
Sure, because we live upstairs.
So why build a theater? Why not just put it down in the basement and play it there? Why
it is down in the basement. I hadn't designed this as a theater in the first place. I just wanted a big place to put the organ so it would sound good. And then they start tearing these theaters down. That's when I got the idea about fixing it up like a movie palace so people could see what a movie palace was like back in the 20s, because many of them have already disappeared.
At Fred's palace, the 20s are roaring back. From the balcony to the main floor, the chandeliers to the seats, the place is stocked with movie house memorabilia. Fred says there's stuff in here from about 50 different theaters from across the country. His home theater has become a popular stop for guests and tour groups wanting a closer look. And when you hear the story...
The organ came into the world the same month and the same time that I did. Middle of March 1926.
You get the feeling the organist and the organ are meant to be.
There are 88 keys on the piano keyboard. I'm on the 88th key right now. And then they say, what are you going to do then? I said, turn the organ, there's 300 more keys on the organ. So that means that I'll live maybe another 50 years or so.
Well played, Fred. Well played. Fred usually puts on 20 to 25 shows a year. He charges $600 per busload or $20 per person. His show is about 90 minutes long with mostly Broadway show tunes.
And he appears to not be shy about taking questions.
Oh, definitely not. He loves to talk about the organ and the restoration. If you want more information, you can go to realracine.com. His shows will begin again in April.